Well, as promised earlier, we have some special guests over in Studio A, and at this time, I'm going to send it over there to Kelly Epperson, and he can tell you all about it.
Hey, thank you, Kenneth. Kenneth Barrier on the Mountain Midday Show. You know, it's not every day we have two legends to drop by the studio, Studio A, but today we're blessed to have with us right now, live and in person. I'm looking right at him. We got Jack Hinshelwood, and we've got Wayne Henderson. I told you we had two legends here today. They're involved in a special program. This would have been Doc Watson's 100th birthday year, and it's called Doc at 100, and Jack and Wayne are going to tell us a little more about what they've been doing and what's still happening, and you still have an opportunity to catch a program or two. So Jack and Wayne, thank you for coming by.
Thank you so much for that thought right there. That's good as it gets, you know. And we're very happy to be out celebrating Doc's birthday. And he was a close friend of mine and hung out in my shop. And I picked with him a little bit. And he's always been my main heroes, and also Jack's, too. And Jack, I don't think got to hang around him and pick with him and stuff as much as I did. But he's still – he knows more of Doc's licks and stuff about him than I do, or anybody else, probably.
Right.
And we've been having a great time, and I really appreciate getting to be here at PAQ. I remember Mr. Ralph, and they hardly ever been nobody, I don't think, more important to our kind of music than Ralph Epperson was. And he, you know, with what he did with this radio station, give people like us an opportunity to play and be on the radio, and I'll never forget him and his stuff that he did with this station, and this station's always been an important thing to me. And you know, I ran a mail route for years, and Sherry Boyd used to be on here at the show. I'd listen to her every day, kept right. my mail route going, and kept me company, and everybody.
That was about what, 10 years ago or so?
Yeah, it's probably been more than that, I'd say. I hate to think about how long ago that's been.
That's been a long time ago. That's probably been back in the 90s and 80s and all.
I think it was, for sure. And then we used to come down here and play live right in this studio right here with Mr. Johnson. And
Clyde Johnson.
So that's always been exciting to me, and I'm excited to be here. And my fingers ain't limber, and I can't pick like I used to, but me and Jack will try to do something and try to promote this show. We're doing one up in Blacksburg.
That's the next show?
That's our next show.
Okay.
At the Moss Center. That's I remember playing in there at least one time before.
Did you say Moss?
It's a beautiful.
Moss or moss?
Moss, like moss that grows on the side of a tree, I think.
Moss. Okay. Yeah. Like green moss.
Yeah.
Okay.
And from E. Buckley Moss, ain't that the lady it's named after, was a great artist and, you know, drawed great pictures and got super famous doing that. And I think she donated a lot of money to get that place built and everything. So they named it after her. And
that's on November 1st?
November 1st.
That's a Wednesday, isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Wednesday night. That'll be a week from tonight.
Yeah. I guess that's right.
Wednesday, November 1st.
Yeah.
What time does the show start?
Jack, about 7 o'clock.
Okay.
That's what they've been, the most of them have been. So
do
about
you have
7
any
o'clock.
Any other helping you guys pick?
Oh, yeah. We've got the main ones. Old T. Michael Coleman, you know, that played on the road with Doc for longer than anybody ever. And Jack Lawrence was his backup guitar player. And those two guys are pretty amazing. You know, they both still play real good and can tell good stories about Doc, and that's part of our show. You know, we talk about, those guys can talk about being on the road and playing with him for years. Jack, maybe 27 years.
Wow.
Something he played and backed him up. And T. Michael, longer than that, was his bass player. And they tell really good, cool stories about Doc and stuff. And I can tell a little bit about him, mostly just hanging out in my shop. And he loved to, especially in his later years, he loved to hang out in my shop. And Doc was a pretty amazing person. You know, somebody blind like that, he was pretty amazing what he could do. He could do electrical wiring. He was like like Mr. Epperson. He liked to mess with wires and electronic stuff, and Doc was good at that. And to imagine how you could do that being blind, you know, right. If I had my eyes shut, I'd electrocute myself the first thing, you know.
You and I both.
And but he loved doing that stuff. He was up at my house one night picking, jamming, and which he'd come do once in a while. He got the feeling of the chair. He always wanted an old straight back chair to fix, you know, to pick in.
Uh-huh.
And I got him the best picking chair I had, but the bottom was all, you know, broken and frazzed out, you know, but it still sat fine.
Yeah.
He got the feeling of it along the bottom and said, Wayne, I need to fix this thing for you. And I guess he detected some doubt in my voice that somebody blind could cane a chair, you know.
Yeah.
And he said, Charles, put this thing in the truck. And Charles Welch has always drove him around, especially up to my place. And he was back over there in a week or so. He usually wouldn't have been back to visit the house or the shop for a month or so. And he's right over there the next week, and he had that chair and wanted me to see it. And it's absolutely the prettiest cane job. Split oak, you know, half-inch wide split oak strips and that herringbone pattern. And he learned to do that at the school for the blind in Raleigh when he was a teenager. And that chair, I sit in it this morning to,
that's
to
amazing.
Eat breakfast, you know.
Wow. Wow. He could do that, cool. Not able to see. But
it's just amazing.
It is.
And to be such a masterful musician, you know, that he was. And I mean, if I shut my eyes, I'll miss more licks than I normally do, you know.
I fall way short of you, Wayne, and Wood of Doc, and it's amazing what he could do despite his short, you know, his disadvantage that he had.
Yeah. And he was you know, very wonderful person. He acted like my grandpa or something, you know. He'd come around, and he liked hanging in my shop, you know, with, I guess, all those guitars, you know, and he'd pick up a piece of wood, he'd tap on it like that, and say, this is the F chord. That'll make a good instrument.
How about
and
that?
And he could hear that good, you know, and something, I mess with wood all the time and listen to the tone and stuff, but I never know what it is, you know, and Doc could hear so good that he could tell.
He was a real genius, wasn't he?
I think he was an absolutely a genius, is all there is to it.
Yeah. And, well, you all pick some. We'll talk some more Doc stories. What are you going to play for the first one here?
Well, we might try to play Windy and Warm. That is one of Doc's famous, finger-picking tunes.
Absolutely.
You know, he was maybe more famous for his flat-picking tunes, you know, but this is a good finger-picking tune, and it's a... I don't know. I'm sure he learned it from Chet Atkins or somebody like that. A tune written by John D. Loudermilk.
Okay.
And, you know, a fellow that wrote country songs. But he did this one instrumental. And it's one that got famous anyway. So me and Jack's going to see if we can do that for you.
Thank you.
All right, windy and warm.
Yep.
There we go. That was great.
About what the weather's been up at the house lately.
It's turned that way. It sure has.
Yeah.
Wayne Henderson and Jack Hinshelwood, thank you guys. You just keep picking for a little while if you want to, and we'll talk some more in a bit.
Okay. Well, what tune are you going to do?
This is a gospel number that Doc recorded that we have enjoyed doing on some of the shows. It's called Old Camp Meeting Time. Long ago, when but a boy at old camp meeting time, how my heart did leap with joy to hear the old bells chime, calling all the saints of God into the house of prayer. Oh, such preaching, praying, shouting, for the Lord was there. I like the old time preaching, praying, shouting, singing. I like the old time reading of God's word. I like to hear those glory hallelujahs ringing. I like the old time worship of the Lord. Preaching in them good old days was filled with holy flame, preaching for the souls of men and not for worldly fame. Under such old-fashioned teaching, sinners fell to pray, and the Lord would save them in that good old-fashioned way. I like the old-time preaching, praying, shouting, singing. I like the old-time reading of God's word. Hallelujah's ringing. I like the old time worship of the Lord. In these latter days, they say there is no use to pray. All we need is to think religion, it's a better way. But I'm here to tell you, brother, Jesus saves from sin. In that old time way he saves me, now he dwells within. I like the old time preaching, praying, shouting, singing. I like the old time reading of God's word. I like to hear those glory hallelujahs ringing. I like the old singing. I like the old time reading of God's word. I like to hear those glory hallelujahs ringing. I like the old time worship of the Lord. Yes, I like the old time worship of the Lord.
Very good. We're getting a good response already.
Oh, are we?
Yeah, Mr. Tommy Nichols said to tell Wayne and Jack hello. They said y'all are sounding really good.
He's a friend of ours, and he's comes up to my shop every once in a while. Actually, was by there yesterday.
Yeah, how about that? Yeah. Well, that's good.
Do you want to send a shout out to bass playing?
Get a little closer to the mic when you talk. That'd be good.
Okay. Yep. We can get over here a little closer. Send a shout out to my old buddy Herb Key that I play music with all the time. He's still around with us and picks and sings and plays with me quite a bit. And today is his birthday. He's 87 years old. I'm all the time talking about him. You know, Herb gets out and works and keeps bees and gardens and does all that stuff all the time and looks in wonderfully good shape for somebody to be that age. And I'm all the time talking about when we play, I announce him and talk about him being 87 years old. And I'm, you know, I'm 77 about, and he's 87. Tell him we're the geezers of the band. But old Herb, I tell him he's 87, and he certainly does not look it, but we can remember when he did.
You're a sight. Oh, my goodness.
So that Herb has to put up with that. And so we send a little shout-out for his birthday today.
Sounds good.
Happy birthday, Herb. And, you know, you mentioned when we got started here about two legends in the studio, and I think you got it spot on as far as Wayne's concerned, but I'm not old enough to be a legend.
you look it, though.
Oh, me. But anyway, we really do appreciate the chance to come on and pick a little bit and talk about this next show, which it's benefiting the Montgomery Museum of Art and History, and they have been wonderful contributors to their community. Their offices are in Christiansburg, and this concert Wednesday night's to benefit them over in Blacksburg at Virginia Tech at the Moss Arts Center. So hope folks, if folks are interested in attending that, they can go on the museum's website and find the events and get to a ticket link. And those are, that's their address on the internet is montgomerymuseum.org. And that's where they can find out everything everything they need to know to be able to come up next Wednesday night and hear the show with Wayne and myself and T. Michael Coleman and Jack Lawrence, as well as Ted Olson. He's our concert host and MC, and Ted was nominated for a Grammy for the book he wrote about Doc's career and life called Doc's World Traditional Plus. And Doc used to describe his music that way, that he played traditional music plus, you know, other things, that other types of music that he loved to play and so forth. So Ted is our the MC and has talked to so many people who played with Doc and were influenced by Doc when he was putting that book together. And so he shares stories from and insights from that whole process. And we try to have the audience share stories that they might have. And people, even if they never met Doc, many people have, you know, a story about how much his music impacted them and enriched their lives. So we like to give folks a chance to share those when we come to the concerts. So,
Jack, when will the program begin that night?
It'll begin at 7, and what we normally do, Ted opens up the show and gives, you know, talks a little bit about why Doc was so important to music, and then Wayne and I believe, will probably open the show, play a little short set together, followed by T. Michael and Jack come out and do a duet after us. And then we have an intermission, and the last half of the show is all four of us on stage playing especially some of the things that were Doc's, you know, tunes that were favorites of people from Doc's repertoire that people really recognize instantly, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And that's typically how the shows go, and we've had some wonderful evenings.
How many shows have you done already?
About 10 or so. We played at the Birchmere, which was really wonderful to go to a place that Doc played at quite a few times. And we played
the Billy Strings thing. That was a big deal.
Oh, wow.
That's right.
Was that in Winston-Salem?
Yeah.
Billy
yeah.
Strings?
Yeah.
Right
at the Coliseum down there.
Right.
And at the Ramcat and in Winston-Salem's a wonderful music hall. So
in old back some, here don't get to play
for 15,000 people every night, you know.
Well, maybe you're playing for 15,000 right now on the radio.
Yeah, we may probably are now.
Yeah, or more. I hope.
See them.
I hope. Yeah. Yeah. Well, now tell me, what kind of reaction are you getting from people who are coming out to these shows?
Nobody's thrown any tomatoes yet that I know of, and everybody's been certainly complimentary, and again, they've shared these stories about what Doc meant to them. It's wonderful to hear those. I've heard so many stories I didn't know until we started this whole process. And, you know, I think my favorite one I've learned about is, I didn't know until we got into this that Doc had a younger sister who was also blind. Her name was Ethel. And Ethel recalled, and this tells you to me what kind of a person, what kindness of spirit Doc had. He was rough and tumble, did all the kinds of things that his brothers did, fell out of trees and all sorts of things. And he was in a cherry tree one time picking cherries, and Ethel came out and wanted to taste some cherries and asked Doc to send her some down. And he said, well, I can do better than that. He said, I'll make a sling out of this rope, and I'll lower it down, and you can sit in that, and I'll pull you up, and you can sit up here and eat cherries all day long if you want to. And I thought that said a lot about Doc and his character and his coming along. You know, he had a sister who was also blind that he could demonstrate, kind of like his dad, who put him on one end of a cross-cut saw, taught Doc a wonderful lesson about being able to do for himself. Doc, I think, took that same approach with Ethel. You know, he said, well, I could throw you down some, but you could come up here and pick them yourself.
Wow.
So that's maybe one of the stories I've enjoyed learning about Doc the most.
That's really neat. Really neat. So on Wednesday night, November 1st, beginning at 7 p.m., this will be at the Moss
Arts Center.
Arts Center on the campus of Virginia Tech.
Yes.
Okay. And what is the cost?
The cost is, you can get tickets right now, again, at that montgomerymuseum.org website, and they're $25. I think they're $30 a day of the show.
Okay, so $25 in advance, montgomerymuseum.org?
Yes.
Okay, montgomerymuseum.org, you can purchase online, $25 in advance and $30 at the door, which is a bargain. To be able to celebrate Doc Watson's 100th year. He would have been 100 years old this year. To hear Wayne Henderson and Jack Hinshelwood and T. Michael Coleman and, oh my goodness, Jack Lawrence. And you said Ted Olson?
Yes.
What a night. Oh my. What a bargain.
And if I could, I'd love to say thank you to, you know, the sponsor folks that make things like this possible. There's Assets Solutions Corporation there in Blacksburg. Focus One Integrated Financial Planning has been a wonderful supporter. Mike Eggleston is a realtor up in that area. And the Vi College of Osteopathic Medicine has been a great supporter of the museum for several years. And the Inn at Virginia Tech, they're a sponsor of the event. And just had some wonderful support in the community for the museum, and this is a benefit for them. Folks like Shelter Alternatives and Dwight Atkinson with Nest Realty. So just want to shout out to those different folks and thank them so much for making it possible for us to go play some Doc.
Yeah. Let's hear some more of that.
All right. Well,
what would you want to do, Jack?
How about we do? Doc was not only an incredible guitarist, but played harmonica, which was the first instrument his dad ever. His dad gave him a harmonica. That was the first instrument he ever put his hands on. if you don't count the wire strung onto the barn door that he liked to thump on.
I think he played his harmonica along with that, too.
Say that again.
Doc told me this story. They had a barn, you know, on their farm or place they lived, like probably all of us did. And I know there was one at our barn did the same thing. It had a big slide door that, you know, you slide the big door open, and then you go in where all the stalls and things were. And Doc stretched a wire, just a piece of fence wire, on that door and tied it to the other side of the wall, you know, and where that door slides. And he would sit with his back against the door jamb and put his foot against the door, and he could put pressure on that door and pick that string. And it made he said that was actually his first string instrument, which it would have been. And that will absolutely work. I've messed with it myself a little bit. Wow. And stretch that wire on the door, and it what it does, it uses the whole side of the barn for a soundboard, like the top of this guitar here, and, you know, stretches a string to it. And then he would sit there and play his harmonica and stretch that, pick on that string at the same time and put the tension with his foot. And, of course, Doc's ear, like I said a while ago, was so amazing that I bet it sounded pretty daggone good.
Yeah.
With one string. And he said he got a brand new harmonica for Christmas every year. And he'd do, you know, stuff like that. And that was a cool thing. He's a great harmonica player, and Jack's got his neck brace on here. And,
yeah. Well, he was a real innovator, wasn't he?
He was an innovator about stuff like that. So
let's hear some.
All right. Well, we'll do one that Doc his own family had a version of that was so famous by the Kingston Trio, called Tom Dooley. But this is Doc's version.
Head, Tom Dooley, hang your head and cry. Kill poor Laurie Foster, and you know you're about to die. Took her on the hillside for to make her your wife. Took her on the hillside, and there you took her life. Dug the grave 4 feet long, dug it 3 feet deep. Rolled the cold clay over her and tromped her with your feet. Hang your head, Tom Dooley, hang your head and cry. Kill poor Laurie Foster, and you know you're about to die. Trouble, all this trouble, a-rolling o'er my breast. Long as I'm living, boys, ain't a-gonna let me rest. I know they're gonna hang me, tomorrow I'll be dead. Though I never even harmed a hair on poor little Laurie's head. Hang your head, Tom Dooley, hang your head and cry. Kill poor Laurie Foster, and you know you're about to die. And one more than reckon where I'll be. If it hadn't been for Sheriff Grayson, boys, I'd be in Tennessee. You can take down my old violin, play it all you please. For at this time tomorrow, boys, it'll be of no use to me. Hang your head, Tom Dooley, hang your head and cry. Kill poor Laurie Foster, and you know you're about to die. Time tomorrow, where do you reckon I'll be? Way down yonder in the hollow, hanging on a white oak tree. Hang your head, Tom Dooley, hang your head and cry. Kill poor Laurie Foster, and you know you're about to die.
Excellent. Y'all keep going. Had a request for Greenville Trestle High. Do you do that?
I do not know the words to that song, so I apologize. I hope they had a second choice.
Yeah. Get just a little closer. Say that again.
I said I apologize. I don't know the words to that one. I hope if they have a second choice, they'll let us know.
All right.
That's great. Boy, this is wonderful. Just keep going. I'm in awe over here. Wayne Henderson and Jack Hinshelwood entertaining us, and it's called Doc 100, right?
Doc at 100.
Doc at 100 is the series that is going on right now. It has been for a little while, and thankfully this is not over yet. The next program is a week from today. It's a week from tonight on November 1st. It's a Wednesday night at 7 p.m. at the Moss Entertainment Center?
The Moss Arts Center.
Moss Arts Center.
Of Virginia Tech.
Virginia Tech University. Wow. And so you can go to montgomerymuseum.org to get your advance tickets and save a little money. And you can get tickets at the door. All right. Go ahead, fellas.
Well,
let's play this instrumental tune. And it's actually an old-timey song called I Don't Love Nobody. And Doc, when he started making those records back in the 60s that made us all want to learn how to play the guitar, you know, he was pretty famous for taking old-time songs, you know, like a singing song or something like that, turning it into a flat-picking guitar instrumental. And this is one of those songs that he done that with, and it's actually an old-timey song called I Don't Love Nobody. And Doc told me this story right here himself about what happened to that, and said when he recorded this song, I don't remember where it was, probably way off somewhere in some studio, I don't know, but when he recorded this song and picked it, and of course he burned it up on the guitar, the recording engineer didn't know what it was and asked him the title of that song, I guess so he could put it down on the record. And Doc misunderstood him and thought he was bragging on his picking. And Doc said, oh, there ain't nothing to it. And when the record came out, that was the title of that song, Nothing to It. And Doc always called this tune Nothing to It. Every time I ever heard him play it, he'd call it. He recorded it a few times in different ways. And we're going to see if we can play it sort of like Doc did here. And one of my favorite picking tunes anyway, the one called Nothing to It. Thank you.
great. Just keep going for a little bit longer, if you would. Well, I hate to run y'all off. I don't want to. I'm going to lock the door so you can't get out.
Well, thank you, Kelly. We appreciate that, but I've got to get back up the mountain and work on these guitars.
Well, I don't want to hurt that. And, so. But maybe another 5-10 minutes, if you could.
Yeah, we'll do. Okay. Jack, he's the brains of the outfit. He'll figure out something to play.
And, how about southbound? Do y'all do southbound?
That's another one. T. Michael wrote that. Doc and Merle wrote that.
Yeah, Merle, Doc. I think, mostly, and Doc. But T. Michael does play that sometimes.
I like
on
that
our
one.
Show.
And Tennessee Stud, I always liked that one.
Yeah, they do. We do that one about every night, and I don't know. That's one I never did play much, you know.
And Black Mountain Rag.
Black Mountain Rag, that's a good one. Maybe if Doc's got if Jack's got another, that happened to you that
whatever
time.
Yeah, whatever you want to play.
Maybe sing something.
Well, how about I play one, and then you be thinking about something you'd like to pick, and then we'll wrap it up with a little Black Mountain.
Okay.
Good.
How's that sound?
That sounds great.
All righty. My favorite song in all the whole wide world, and Doc played this and recorded it more than once, I think, some on banjo, and guitar, and so forth, called Shady Grove. Of my heart, sweetest little girl in town. Shady Grove, my true love. Shady Grove, I say. Shady Grove, my true love. I'm about to go away. Last time I saw Shady Grove, she's standing in the door with her shoes and stockings in her hand and her little bare feet on the floor. Every time I pass this way, it's always dark and cloudy. Every time I see that gal, I always tell her howdy. Shady Grove, my true love. Shady Grove, I say. Shady Grove, my true love. I'm about to go away. Summertime and apples in the fall. If I can't have the one I love, don't want none at all. Shady Grove, shiny love. Shady Grove, I say. Shady Grove, my true love. I'm about to go away. Some come here to fiddle and dance. Some come here to parry. Some come here to fiddle and dance. I came here to marry. Shady Grove, my true love. Shady Grove, I say. Shady Grove, my true love, I'm about to go away.
Outstanding. So you're going to pick out one, Wayne, and then you're going to close with Black Mountain Rag?
Yeah, I think so. This,
all right.
Maybe I might play this. I play this tune every night about when we go out to play. It's Steel Guitar Rag, one of my favorite tunes to play. And Doc definitely recorded this and once, if not a couple of times. But he'd always play it a little bit. And Jack, if you play me a little rhythm there, I'll And I appreciate you folks for letting us come down here and giving me one more chance to be in this old studio again. And, you know, at my age and my finger moving abilities, you know, you never know if you'd ever get to do that again, you know.
Well, we're tickled. Cool. Anytime you want to come in, Wayne, we'll stop whatever we're doing and let you play.
Well, I appreciate that a sight. And I certainly appreciate what you all done, what you have done. This station's been here about the same age I am.
Yeah.
It's been, yeah. I believe, I'm not fooled, it opened in 1948.
You got it.
I was born in 1947, and so it's been here since I was one, you know.
Well, we feel honored that we're both about the same age.
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Thank you.
I'll play this tune. I play this one about every night. It's the steel guitar rag, and it's one of my favorite tunes to play. And Doc definitely recorded that one time. And I bet he listened to Bob Wills's Leon McAuliffe steel guitar player. I bet he learned it the same place, probably. So this one I love to play, and I'll see if I can get through his steel guitar rag here. Good steel guitar rag. Yep, that's a.
You want me to go ahead and just tell everybody again about the program one more time before you do Black Mountain Rag?
That would be great. And I'd like to also echo Wayne's thanks for having us on PAQ. It's more than a radio station, it's an institution.
Yeah,
well, thank you.
Big deal. I don't think many places they would let us just come in off the street and come in here and pick, and that's an old-timey thing to me and something like that, and I bet there's not many radio stations in the world that would let you come in here and do this. And
we probably wouldn't get past the front door much, would you?
No, I don't think so.
Well, let me just tell everybody again that Doc at 100 concert program celebrating the life and legacy of Doc Watson by artists who performed with Doc, who were profoundly influenced by his music and who called him a friend. And we've been having a live session plugging this great concert program with Jack Hinshelwood and, of course, Wayne Henderson. And T. Michael Coleman will join Wayne and Jack along with Jack Lawrence and Ted Olson And this program is coming up on Wednesday, November 1st at 7 p.m. And the place is the Moss Arts Center, if I'm not mistaken, Moss Arts Center at Virginia Tech in Blacksburg, Virginia. Not too far from here at all. It starts at 7 p.m. And I've got here the tickets are $30 at the door. $30 at the door and $25 in advance. And children 12 and under, $10. I guess this is Radford University and Virginia Tech students are $15. All proceeds benefit the Montgomery Museum. Go to montgomerymuseum.org, montgomerymuseum.org, and purchase your tickets. I'm on the site right now. It's real easy to navigate. And what a pleasure it's been to have Jack Hinshelwood and Wayne Henderson here in Studio A. So take it out with Black Mountain Rag, and then you can have it back, Kenneth.
Live from Studio A, that was Wayne Henderson along with Jack Hinshelwood and the Black Mountain Rag.